A user is anyone who logs into Salesforce. All right, sounds simple enough. But who would have a login to Salesforce in the first place? It's a great question. This could be the end users of Salesforce, so employees, sales reps, managers, support teams, anyone who's getting into Salesforce to enter information. But it could also be those who are charged with managing and improving Salesforce, so admins, developers, even consultants from other companies. It could even actually be other platforms that are integrated with Salesforce, so not even humans at all. The bottom line is that every user in Salesforce that logs in to Salesforce has a user account. The user account is where we store all the information about that particular user. It includes all your basic information, things like name, email, username, title, what time zone are you in? But it's also where we can see some more advanced information about the user and their behavior. Sounds spooky? Don't worry, it's actually super useful information that can help us control the security of our org and make really informed decisions. For example, on the user account, we can see if they've been trying to log in with the wrong password. This is super useful if a user calls you with login issues. We can also see how many times they've logged in over any given time period, what groups they're part of, what security settings they have assigned to them. We can see their license, their username, and the currency that they operate in. We can even see who their manager is and where they sit in the organization hierarchy. It's really the one-stop shop for getting an entire overview of each user, and it's where we go to solve almost all of their Salesforce problems. To add a new user, we can simply go to Users in Setup and then click on New User. Then we can just fill out all the appropriate information, and voila, they're off. We can even decide if we want to generate a password for them immediately in that very moment, or you can wait until a later date to get them logged on. This is really great for setting up one user, but what do you do if you want to add multiple users at once? Do you have to add them all individually? No, of course not, it's Salesforce. If we wanted to add up to 10 users at once, we can use the Add Multiple Users button, which is just on the Users page in Setup. This lets us add up to 10 users at once, all with their own profiles and their own roles. The only thing to be careful of here is that everyone who you add in one go must have the same license, and they all need to be using their email address as their username. Now, this may seem like an odd thing to point out. Why does it matter that their email address is the same as their username? Well, there's two very special things that we have to know about usernames for Salesforce users. The first is that each username must be completely unique for Salesforce. They can't have that same username for another Salesforce login, even if it's for a completely different company, on a completely different location, in a completely different industry. It doesn't matter. The username has to be completely unique. The second thing that we have to know about usernames is that they all must be in the format of an email address. But that doesn't mean they have to be a real email address. For example, you could have the username squigglygoop@notreal.com. This isn't a real email, but it would work as a username because it's in the format of an email. So if we're thinking about using our real email as our username, we have to be really careful because you can only use it once. Once you've used it once as your username, then that's it. You can't use it again. So you can see how this might cause issues when you're adding multiple users at once and using their email address as the username because they might have actually used that before. If you need to add more than 10 users at once, you can do this using the data loader tool, which imports and creates hundreds of users all at the same time. This time you can set their usernames individually, separate to their email, so we're avoiding that whole email username problem. But their license will be chosen based on the profile that you select. Don't worry if that sounds confusing, because we'll be going over licenses and profiles later. Now, sadly, there will come a time when you need to deactivate users in Salesforce. There are two core functions here that we need to be aware of. One is deactivating the user, and the other is called freezing the user. Now, deactivating the user will remove their license from their user account and prevent them from logging in. It's not the same as deleting a user, which you definitely don't want to do. Deleting a user will result in what we call orphaned records in Salesforce. These are records that no longer have an owner or a history. And this makes for really bad data quality in your Salesforce org, because if you were looking back at an account from 2 years ago and you wanted to know who was working on it, if you deleted that person, even if they left, you wouldn't be able to see who that was. It's all been gone. So Salesforce actually doesn't allow you to delete users at all. That ability just doesn't exist. So the only options that we have is those two that we talked about, deactivating and freezing. One of the hardest parts about deactivating a user is that you have to remove them from any automations in Salesforce first. Things like flows, process builder, workflows, assignment rules, approval processes. There's heaps out there that a user could be involved in, but you can't fully deactivate them until they've been removed from all of those. This could cause a problem if that person needs to be locked out of Salesforce straight away. What if they were found to be a security risk to the entire company? What if you don't have time to go through all of these different places and make sure that they're no longer attached to these automations? Enter freezing. When you freeze a user, you stop them from being able to log into Salesforce, but you haven't completely removed their license from their user account yet. It's still there, you're still paying for them, but they can't log into Salesforce. This gives you time to properly deactivate them, remove them from all of those automations, without having to worry about them still logging in and messing around with things. So that's the intro to what users are in Salesforce. We've covered what a user is, what we can see on the user account, how we can add a new user, how we can add multiple users at once. We've talked about usernames versus emails, deactivating and freezing. So really nice work, we've covered a lot, and now it's time to put it all into practice.